I was inspired to become a chemical engineer because I was had some talent in chemistry, had some talent in mathematics, and turned out to be one of the best choices I've made. My name is Tony Butterfield. I am an associate professor lecturer at the University of Utah. My primary responsibility is to produce more chemical engineers. When I explain chemical engineering to K-12 schools, usually I tell them that we are broken down generally into product or process engineers. So a product engineer is looking to make some new widget, some new device. It could be like a kidney dialysis machine, it could be an artificial pancreas, it could be a catalytic converter that goes on the back of your car. A process engineer is looking to take raw materials and make it into something more valuable, like take crude oil, make diesel, jet fuel, gasoline, asphaltenes, a variety of things that we find useful in our day-to-day lives. The skills, experience, and knowledge that have helped me most in my career have, of course, been the technical skills that I picked up along my education. My skills in programming, my skills in mathematics and chemistry have been very helpful. But as an educator, the interpersonal skills I've developed have been very important, because a lot of what I do as a professor does not have to do with solving equations or teaching kids how to program. A lot of it is being there to be supportive for our students and helping them when they have trouble, helping find the right resources for them if they're having financial issues or mental health issues. Both my technical skills and my personal experiences as just a human trying to make it as an engineer have been very valuable. The three most important skills I think our students need are coding skills, so they can analyze their data, read from sensors. Mathematics, so they can properly understand the theory and apply it correctly. Also, technical communication skills, so that they can convey their solutions to others efficiently and effectively. As an instructor of chemical engineering, some of my biggest challenges involve, one, keeping up to date with the chemical engineering field, because it is always changing, and I'm constantly trying to make sure that what we're teaching our students is what they're going to need in the workplace. The other challenge is more on the personal side, so resolving conflicts between students, making sure that our department is welcoming of all students, and just taking care that all the groups that I advise, from our AIChE student chapter to our ChemE car team to our outreach team, that are all being productive and getting the skills out of those experiences that they're going to need to get a job in the future. One of the bigger challenges I faced as a chemical engineer in the 90s was the industry was not very friendly back then to LGBTQ engineers. And me as a gay man and entering into industry just after my bachelor's degree, I experienced some hostility, which actually forced me into graduate school. Nowadays, I am very glad to say that AIChE is there setting the standard for inclusion for LGBTQ plus engineers. For a young chemical engineer starting out, I would recommend you approach somebody that's been through it. I think some of the greatest resources we have for our first year students are our seniors, and creating those relationships for our first year students is valuable because they gain insight into where they're headed. I would absolutely say that one of the most unexpected rewards I've had in my job is getting to meet so many amazing young chemical engineers. There's people that graduated having taken my courses a decade ago that I still keep in touch with. I follow their careers with enthusiasm and excitement. The things that they've gone on to do are frankly amazing, and the benefits that they've carried on to society are equally amazing. And to get to know these quality of people and see what the amazing things they go on to do is it's an honor.